Hi everyone, this is 4th of August and it's the new moon. So I'm going to start off this morning, Sunday morning here in Mexico, with doing the full moon reading for all Librans. Okay, so let's get started. Just lining up this camera here. The best I can do right now, I think. Okay, this is really important because of the times we're in, because of this period that I keep talking about over and over, but I'm just going to mention again to bring it to the forefront of your minds of Pluto in Aquarius. This is the 20-year period. It has gone in and out a couple of times, but for very short periods of time. We're going to be using here, this pack of higher consciousness starseed oracle cards, so that we can really see what we're being asked on those higher levels. So just bear with me, I have pre-shuffled these cards, but I'm going to do them again three times. Actually, let's do five. I'm getting five in my head for some reason. So, new moon. New beginnings, new ways of seeing things, pushing ourselves further on higher consciousness levels. So this keeps us on mission. It's all about every part of us being focused in a higher way, okay, and doing things in a higher way. So the first card out here is Star Bathing. They have some pretty exotic names on these cards, but what I'm trying to do is bring them down to the level that we can understand and use the information. And this is about the crystal grid of the earth. And this is so important that we understand that, that inside this core of our earth, there is a crystal grid. And that we are connected to that. And what we also have to do is connect ourselves to the divine so that we're in the middle of the two energies of living out our existence as a human being in the human temple skin, okay, but pulling in the divine energies from above, from the cosmos. So we have a mission in itself for that. But the first card out here is always in the nine card reading I do. Just seeing whether we can actually still see this. Yes, we can. It's the first card out of the pack is telling us what the whole reading's about. So this truly is about living every day through the highest level of consciousness that we can. And our second card here, this is Star Ancestors, okay? And this is about the lost wisdoms, the secrets that are hidden in the past, in our past lives. I was having a long conversation yesterday when I was out doing readings for a lot of people. And we were talking about how we both knew that we need to pull in every gift that we were ever living out in the past lives that we had. And what came to my mind immediately when I was there was that there are 12 particular lives that we have to reconnect with throughout the lives we've had in order to pull in the gifts. And 12 is good. It's really, really good. If you are taking back and bringing forth again the gifts from 12 different lives, that's pretty amazing. And it may be 12 different civilizations. I find the whole thing about who we are fascinating. Every day, more and more fascinating. Third card out here is Star Family. And this is, again, so important, isn't it? Because we all know that we now need to find our tribe. We need to find those people who are already awakening, who we are going to connect with, and that they also will have parts of the same missions that we do. So we're not just out there surviving now, we're thriving and pulling through the highest consciousness in order to connect up with all these other friendly souls who will know us when they meet us. This is Sunday morning. I hope you're loving the level of this, because I am. Big picture thinking. Pleiades energy, visionary inspired ideals. And this is how I see our future. I see that we're creating this total new existence within a new world with different frequencies. And the big picture is that I am determined to stay on track with that. And recently I received an email asking me whether I wanted to join this very well-known kind of leader from the old age, because it was all about making lots of money and living in your mansion and having holidays in your second holiday home. And he was trying to get people to think about their legacy they were going to leave. But he is not. He has not got the vision for the future, for the real future. And I really felt that I had to write back, and I did. Because these people who've made all the money out of making other people more wealthy now have to start aligning themselves with the real future. And the real future is not about elitism through money and career success. It has nothing to do with that. It has to do with the fact that we are all one. We are all the collective. And the collective is only the strong as the weakest person in that collective. So we are thinking completely different. And I actually told him in my reply that the star seeds are moving this forward, and that we cannot join anything that is talking about our money and success legacy that we're going to leave, and that we're going to keep contributing to charity, which is totally obsolete with the ideas we have. There is no need for charity when everybody has an equal chance, an equal way of living out their truth, their gifts and everything like that, because we are all then equally provided for. Let that sink in. This is a reality that we are moving towards. Total, complete, 100% equality, where resources are not stored in bank accounts of certain people. Resources are given out freely and shared amongst the whole of the collective. Nobody is left out. We're never again going to talk about the 1% and the 99%. Because it's not going to exist. And the divine is making sure of that. And all of the earth changes and the movements and destroying of the old will happen in order for us to walk forward like this. Our middle card, what are we going to be given today? Messenger. This is serious energy bringing in harmony and balance, exactly what I was just talking about. And I know I'm a messenger of that. And I know that not everybody agrees with me, but that's not a problem for me. I've activated my mission. I'm on my mission, and I'm well in underway with helping to bring in this total equality. What is your message? What are you a messenger for? Because we all have parts of this sealed for some still in their higher mind, because they haven't activated yet that part of their higher mind that will give them that. And what they need to do is start healing and balancing out their life, because the ego part has to fall back in order for the higher self to move forward. So the healing of the inner child is a must, because a lot of people are still, through their ego, even though they might have a lot of money and a lot of excess in the bank, they're still thinking they need more, because they're going through the inner child horror of not having enough. And it's all crazy, because all of this is easily healed. Go on to my playlist of fast track to cosmic consciousness and look at the inner healing your inner child and meeting your inner child visualization. Two different videos on that short playlist, which is all about you moving forward into your true missions. Deep cellular healing, again, just what I spoke of. We are preempting here a lot of these cards. This is deep cellular healing, and we need to do that because all the horrors of our childhood as well that went against us, you know, sort of sacred soul self, because our parents weren't awake either, that healing is in our bodies as well. That's why we have a lot of physical illness going on right now, and expected. You know, I'm not one of those people who expects ever to be unwell, out of a state of high wellness. I'm in high wellness. I'm 75, going up to 76 soon. And I have a completely healthy body. So this is possible because you think that way, you eat that way, you live that way, you use the space around you that way. You do not invite people in who are not of the frequency. You may see them temporarily, but you don't have them every day in your lives when they're not able to have conversations with you on the higher level. So this deep cellular healing starts with you, not with the pharmaceutical industry that just makes money out of your symptoms. Let's have it so that we have no pharmaceutical needs, because it is possible. Myself and many, many others are doing that thing. Water your garden. I just love these cards. Couldn't be better for the new moon, for us to have that new beginning. If you haven't started this work, you haven't activated yet what your message is to the world, what your particular message is, then start watering your garden now. Take care of your nourishment, your body care, tenderness, and rest. Because every week that we live out, we need to have a balance of all of those, don't we? Of nourishing ourselves properly, of watering our own garden, just like we take care of plants. You know, there are some people out there who have amazing gardens, but they're almost crippled themselves and they hobble around that garden because they don't nurture themselves the same as they nurture their plants. And even worse, there are a lot of people out there who nurture their toys, their cars, their boats, their planes. Their holiday homes are luxuriously furnished. Their houses have a lot of things in them. But their bodies falling apart. I'm just saying it as it is. You know me by now. 500 and more videos down, you know I'm going to say it as it is. Because as it is your starting point. Do not kid yourself about where you're at, because you will not begin the journey if you do. Trust the timing. Trust the wave you come in on. Time is not running out. There you go. You, if you're hearing this message, get going now on this new moon. Because when we have a new moon, it has those extra energies. There's not so much of the moon out there when it's a new moon. Think of the physical facts of this. The moon is kind of a, you know, when you think of the card in the tarot, or when you think of all the myths about the moon, it's kind of the illusion. So when we're in a new moon, there's not a lot of it there, is there? There's a tiny bit of it there. So it isn't hiding. It isn't hiding us. It isn't shielding us from the real awareness. And that's why new moon is new beginnings. Because there's less of that shielding of us happening. And you have the opportunity to trust the timing, trust that the time is right for you now. Really, sorry, I've got hiccups here. Really for you to trust that you can now start to spotlight what you need to do in your life to move forward quicker. Everything is backing you up on that. The divine wants you to move, wants you to change, wants you to become who you really are, so that you are one of those links active in the chain that is bringing in this new world. Our new world. It's not some, you know, thing out there that's kind of not real. This is our world, the way we always in our souls wanted it to be. The last card here I love too, because it's forge, don't follow, because you do have a unique path. Do not wait for your family to move. Do not wait for your friends to pat you on the back. You need to move with the feelings that you have about what is right in your heart. Because for a lot of us, there has never been anyone backing us up. I don't remember a time when anybody was pushing me forward or pushing me to keep going on my path. I really don't. I mean, now I have a lot of people around me, but, you know, for decades I did not, because they all thought I was a weirdo, that I wasn't chasing the money, that I wasn't chasing relationships, that I wasn't chasing having designer clothes. All I chased was what was inside of me, and tried to discover it and dig deeper and deeper and deeper. And I had to forge that path on my own. So stop following those people around you who are immersed in money, fortune, and false security, who do not know themselves from a rubber ball. Do not follow those people, because, you know, this is who people have followed. And we have these huge financial gurus out there who are still trying to rob us of our soul space. It's a whole false illusion out there. We may get comments on this video, you know, I'm just thinking. Don't bother, because I won't reply to anybody coming up with their falsehoods and their false ideas of what life is about. So which bit is ringing a bell in you today? I hope one of these cards with their expressions of where we're going is ringing that bell really hard inside of you, so that you awaken more and use this energy from today onwards. For the next, say, 7 days, it's going to be really powerful. So put your intentions out there now for what you want, and start putting the disciplines in, because it's not going to happen to you. It's going to happen for you from your own energy. I'm not going to hold your time. It's a leisure time, isn't it? Sundays for us, it's a time of reflection. It's a time when we're with our families and our friends and not working, hopefully. So just, if you do like the level at which I'm pitching these readings, then please like the video, because this does help the algorithm take our message out there further. And subscribe if you want to hear my daily take on what we need to focus on, because that too is on a higher level. It's on the new level. It's on the level we need to have coming from us every day now. So have a great day, and thank you for allowing me into your sacred space today on this new moon.